Dynamics, making a show video. I've got a few razors, and the first one is Friday, James Johnson, and quite happy with this one. Last night I honed Thursdays up. Thursdays was the worst one for pitting, and is in bad shape. And I honed it up, and the pitting up here right on the very toe, on the very end, it was on the bevel. And by the time I'd got rid of it, the bevel had come up a bit. So I'm going to take it back to the workshop today, later on. Don't want to, but it's for the best. And I'll have another go at it. And I should have Thursday ready for next week, but here's Friday. And just to prove there's no funny business going on, there you go, you can see it says Friday, I think. There you go, right. Full Nagora progression on the Izuku Kitta. And we've got this little fella. Did something different with this. Did it on the Izuku Kitta as well. Not a full progression. And then what I want to hopefully have a full shave with, if it shaves well, is this Joseph Rogers. This is the coffin box, obviously, but inside. Nice. I did restore this box and adjust the lid now, so it's nice and firm. It's clean, hygienic. It's a bit rough, this one, but I just sort of flew through the process. Wanted to get a shave of this because I couldn't just let it go by the wayside. So here's the Joseph Rogers. It also says the favorite ring. You can see the finish on it that I give it. I mean, it was covered in rust and it was really in a bad way. So I kind of did some grinding on it. It's quite difficult because you can only get a 1-inch wheel in there. And unless the 1-inch wheel protrudes, sticks out, which mine doesn't, and I've only seen a few that do, you can't really get the blade on it. You've got to be at an angle, so it's all a bit dodgy. But this went through everything, really. I gave it a bit of greaseless, and a bit of this and that, and just ended up with like a satin finish. But look at the grind on that. It's a, yeah, it was 15/16, and that's a 7/8, but there's no belly on it. It's just a sheer straight grind. It's got a really thick tang on it. A really thick tang and spine, and it's long as well. I mean, the only comparison I've got is that, you see what I'm talking about? It's quite a big razor. So the shaving cream I've got is D.I. Harris 29. That's their house number on St. James's. But I should also show you, we're on the usual, the D.I. Harris and the Plisson. Not that much. It smells, if I say powdery, I'm not sure if you know what I'm talking about, but. Right, so the James Johnson. Let's see what happens. Yeah, that's really nice. Yep. We're happy with that. That could go in the that can go in the case. I think that's an improvement. So with this, I just went from the 5K. I set the bevel and whatnot on the 5K, and then I did some coma and tomo. Just don't think it's all that. I'm sure there are camisories that deliver amazing edges, but I'll carry on messing about with it. I do like using it because you don't have to worry about water getting up in the pivot. So I do like honing it. It's quite nice to hone. It's nice to strop as well, actually, because it's so small. Right, let's go with the Joseph Rogers. Oh my God, I've cut myself with the cami. No, it's not a cut. There's blood, so yeah, it's a cut. Something's happened. Oh my Lord, that feels good. It feels like a... I was going to say filly, but... I don't know, it's quite unique, actually. I can't actually feel the edge, which... for a hollow grind is... quite unusual. It's like paper thin. But, yeah, it's unique. Oh, wow. Feels nice. Does say England on this. And I always steer away from the razors that say England, but over the years, forced to change my thoughts. Because I've had some really good razors. Does it say England with this? It's definitely got something about it. See what happens by the end. But with this razor, it took a hell of a long time to sort the edge out because the heel was quite large, so it tapered up. It's just the way it had been honed. So I had to bring the heel down, and it took a lot of work, more than you think. I mean, stuff like that. I just do it on a 1K with a slurry, like a 45 degree angle, circles, you know, tilting it and removing the steel from where I want. And after the 45 degrees to get honing all the way to the edge, it took ages. So it took long enough to let me know that it's not soft. The steel's not soft. So, because of that, I did a full Nagora progression. Something like this, I wouldn't do that normally, this kind of a grind. Because of how long it took to straighten the edge, that's why I went with the full progression. And it worked out well. It's like deadly sharp, but that's what I mean unique. It's definitely unique because I can't actually feel the edge. thinking, I will put this on the site with all the other razors that are supposed to be on the site already, but I can't ask a lot for it because the finish is not very nice, but I have to think about it. I thought it'd be just a £100 razor, but it's a little bit beyond that. But see, a £100 razor, I don't have to take, I can just like roughly take some photos and make a little collage. Anything over £100 gets its own listing and it's more effort. I have to take separate photos, but we'll see. But it's definitely a nice razor. As well, I should mention the site, the website. I mean, I don't really want to talk about it, it's that bad. Because if you clicked on straight out of the holder last week, if you clicked on a photo, if you clicked on a razor, there was no photos of that razor. So I was in talks with them. They're fixing it, they're trying to fix it. And I mean, I wasn't too bothered. I know it'd get fixed, kind of, but by Friday evening, I noticed someone contacted me and they said, the razor that you sold me, you said it was the only one, like on earth, but you've got another one on your website. So I got home from work, had a look at the website, and it's like they'd rolled it back, like maybe a year or... Basically, there was razors there that I'd sold, they'd already sold. And there's probably some on there still that have sold. There's a George Butler, I think it's like £150, I'm sure I've sold it. That's there. I've removed about six razors that I know I've definitely sold. And it's like all the work I'd done on the history page, I'd made all the photos black and white and changed their pixels and borders, and that's all reverted. I don't know if in the £100 razors, the £50 razors, that must have reverted back showing stuff that's sold. It's just a mess. It's like it's showing the, if you look at the razors, there's pictures that don't fit in like the box, and I changed that. I'm sure that was over a year ago. I changed that. I fixed every picture. So it's, the whole website is in a mess. It might mean the postage is reverted as well, how it used to be. So I've made a complaint, and I mean, you can't contact these people on the weekends. I've got to wait till tomorrow. But it's a lesson in self-control, how not to let something play on your mind and ruin your weekend. To sum it up in a sentence, the website is knackered at the moment. And I mean, like my PC, I can roll back, but you can't roll forward unless you've got a later save. So we'll see what they do, what they say. And also as well, on Friday I got home, I saw all this mess, I was quite upset about it, and then they sent me two emails. One was a bill for the month and the other one was a feedback, to give them feedback. Unbelievable. I think that's one of the closest shaves I've had. Go a step further. Very nice. So you don't need Philharmonicas and all that. Just need one of these. And I have been in the workshop. The one in the Stag. I tried to swap it over for a bigger blade. Exact same shape, just 2.5 millimeters wider. But the Stag horn, as it was warped to start with, and it's reverted back to that. So I remember trying to straighten it. I did straighten it, but it's just gone back. So I'm messing about with that, trying to get that straight, which is a bit of an impossible task. So we'll see how that plays out. But yeah, I've got a few other razors that I'm working on. And I've got a Joseph Rogers that Joseph Rogers no I've got a John and William Rag that could be one of my favourites. It's not like a super, you know, mother of pearl thing, but I really got something about it. And during the week, I want to mess about with that. It doesn't need a lot of work, just a little bit. But we'll see. But either way, that is a super, super close shave. Really comfortable as well. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you next week. Bye.